So just thinking about the process we went through to build the business case. Now, just to let you know, this isn't linear. It's like a sale. And I think, when you're a salesperson, which a lot of us have been, and you're talking to a customer, you'd love just to go through from your one stage to the next stage. And everyone wants to get to that closed won business and get our commission check. Unfortunately, then there's reality, and it doesn't always work that way. You might have a conversation, you do your qualification, you do discovery, and you bounce back and forth. And so when I thought about the business, the process to building the business case, it was a similar approach in that we had to have our clear steps on what we wanted to do. We wanted to know what we knew what the goal was, where we wanted to get there, but how we got there was what we needed to work on. And as I spoke about earlier, if you think about the structure at Sage, it wasn't just a simple conversation with the chief marketing and enablement officer. There was a number of stakeholders across the business that would need to be aligned to our thinking of what we were doing. So the process for me was, number one, is we had to be very clear on what we were going to focus on. And this is where metrics came in and was really important. What were we going to drive by making this investment? What was that return on investment? So step one was being very clear on and be able to articulate the focus areas and what those metrics would be. Number two was making sure that the regions were then aligned to what those focus areas, or let's call them priorities, would be, and make sure that the metrics that we have would then also stand up in those regions. So it's very easy to, when you're doing it from a central standpoint, you can just roll it all up and say, right, this is what we expect to do. But when you're sitting in a region, you're an MD, and you're asking him to put a couple of $100,000 up here, you need they need to have the level of confidence in you that your numbers are going to drive what you're saying they're going to drive. So it was important that we did that. And again, that's step two. You needed to do it across all the regions. Okay. In step three was now consolidating that into a pretty short presentation, and start with the executive alignment. So the first thing I did was make sure that our chief marketing and enablement officer was aligned to our thinking on what we're going to do and what we're going to drive. What was important was for him to then work with the president of our company to then have alignment on that the investment we were going to make was going to drive and align to the strategy of where we were going as a company, thinking not just now, not just in 1 year's time, but in 3 years' time. I'd say for me to one, the 3 year time period or horizon is the best to focus on. I think if you go to 5 years, you're too far out. And if you're doing it sooner, I think we all know technology. By the time you've gone through the pilots, you've rolled it out, and you've got to execute. You've got some metrics to go behind it. You could be six to 9 months in already. So it's important that you make sure that you've got your horizons right. Step four was to make sure that we now get the rest of the exco aligned. So what we would do is to have a number of presentations with exco, and make sure that they understood what the ROI was going to look like, how that would impact the regions, and how that was going to then align, as you heard, to the strategy. And again, you're getting all of exco aligned, which is really important. And then for me, step five was making sure that we could then execute on the timeline that we had now put forward. And because the execution piece is critical. Again, it needs to be flawless, but also that we need to, again, this is behaviors that you're changing. You're bringing in a new technology. You've got to think about the change management aspects. You've got to make sure that when we roll it out, you've got the teams in place to do it. I needed to have the enablement teams and structure in place to be able to do this. This is a lot of people that we rolled in this technology out to. So the step five was what that execution plan would look like, and then what the check-in points would be with exco to make sure that they were getting visibility into what was happening, and that we would be hitting the metrics that we said that we would hit, and the benefits we'd see with this technology.